Hi, I'm Susan Arndt, and this is the video for our review of Dead Island. There's nothing quite like a trip to a tropical resort to recharge your batteries, so long as you can deal with the blistering sun, the drunken guests, and of course the hordes of undead zombies trying to eat your flesh. In Dead Island, the paradise of Benoit has been overrun by a horrible contagion, and now the place is quite literally crawling with throngs of bikini and cargo short wearing undead. You play as one of four characters whose backgrounds not only make them uniquely well-suited to going toe-to-toe with the hungry hordes, but who also happen to be immune to whatever it is that's infecting everyone, which makes you the best choice to leave the nice, cozy safe house and venture out into the dangerous wild for supplies. Great. This means you're going to be spending most of your time in Dead Island up to your elbows in zombie guts as you kick, smack, slash, and shoot your way through legions of the undead. Doesn't ever grow much beyond the kill stuff formula, but the variety of zombies you face keeps the combat nice and fresh. Even the standard zombies vary in speed and ferocity, so you can't be sure if that creep you see is going to shamble on over or come at you full speed. As you make progress through the game, you'll encounter even more dangerous types of undead, like suiciders who explode when they die, and floaters whose vomit is both noxious and flammable. And gross. Really, just, God, that's disgusting. Dead Island takes a bit of inspiration from its fellow zombie romp, Dead Rising, by giving you plenty of quests to take on as you try to survive the onslaught, but it gets rid of the annoying time limit. The quests for the main story are all about survival, while the side quests are a bit more random.
Can you help me?
You want me to risk my life to go get your necklace? Yeah, I'll put off tracking down the life-saving medical supplies to go find your trinket for you, because that's a good use of my time. The quests don't always make sense given your survival situation, but you'll want the experience and cash you get from completing them. Leveling up gives you another crack at improving one of your skill trees, and you'll need the money to fix up your weapons. I have no idea who actually gets the money you spend at the game's workbenches, but they are going to be very, very rich by the time you finally get rescued. Your weapons degrade as you use them, so regular maintenance is the key to keeping them in good killing shape. You can also use the blueprints and supplies you find to create modifications that give your weapons boosts, like extra shock or venom damage. Dead Island is definitely rough in patches, but its co-op is pretty great. Hopping into someone's game is as easy as hitting the D-pad when you're at a point in the story that's close to theirs. Whatever you accomplish together carries back into your solo game, so you can hop in and out as you see fit. Now, I'm not normally a big multiplayer fan, but Dead Island made it so easy to join a game that I found myself joining up with other players just about every chance I got. Dead Island is not as refined as it could be, but it's got tons to do. Quests to complete, collectibles to find, mods to create, and, of course, loads of zombies to kill in new and satisfying ways. Like running them over with a truck, for example. That one's a personal favorite of mine.